when the online classes was going on, I explained the tenses. Again, in the tenses, we have discussed about the present tense. In the present tense, past tense and future tense. But in the present tense, again, four forms we have discussed. In the present tense, also four formations which are there: present tense, present continuous tense, present perfect tense, and present perfect continuous tense. But right now, yesterday, I have completed on the online the two formations, present tense, simple present tense completed, and the present continuous tense also completed. Right now, I am going to explain the present perfect tense. That is the third formation. And next time, present perfect continuous, the fourth formation will be complete. Let us now continue. So right now, that means, first of all, before going to the present perfect tense, we should know present tense, past tense, and past participle. These are the verbs are necessary. These are called irregular verbs. And whenever we are using the present perfect tense, these are the verbs that should be used. So let us see, first of all, eat, ate, past tense is ate, past participle is eaten. And then the present tense is give, past tense is gave, and the past participle is given. Means give, gave, given. Read. But when we are reading that, read. Begin, began, begun. This past participle is using in the present perfect tense. See, saw, seen. This is the seen is used in the present perfect tense. Meet is the present tense. Past tense is met, and the past participle is met. This is the met saying it is coming, that is using in the present perfect tense. Grow, grew, grown. Become, became, became. Go, went, gone. Do, did, done. Break, broke, broken. Come, came, come. So these are the most important. First of all, you have to learn by heart. Then you can use easily in the present perfect tense. What is the present perfect tense? Let us know. Present perfect tense. This tense is used to indicate an action which is just over or completed. Means the action, the verb. That means the verb which is how we have to use in the present perfect tense. That is just has been completed. Today itself only, now itself only, the work which has been completed, that is called a present perfect tense. Let us see what is that. We have to use in the present perfect tense have, has, plus past participle should be used. And then what the examples, let us the examples. In the examples also, three formation I told yesterday, first person, second person, and third person used. It is easily you can write down. I. First person is I. I am telling about myself, that is called I. I have eaten biscuits. That is I said about myself. Second person is you. You means you are telling, that means you have eaten biscuits. Third person is he, she, it. Already we discussed that. This is third person we are going to say, that means the present perfect tense. He has talked too much. And she has given medicine, and the rain, that is called, sometimes we can use, that we have to write in the bracket, it has stopped, otherwise the rain has stopped. Okay, let me see now, have, has, when we are using. In the first person, I, and whenever that means I coming, I have used here, and the past participle, eaten. And then that second person, you have to write down five more sentences about for the first person. Now second person, regarding you, that means I am speaking you. You have eaten. Have, again use that in the have. And eaten, past participle used in the eaten. Have eaten biscuits. Now in the third person, it is the verb have is changed now. That is he has talked too much. Here, when the third persons are coming, we have to use the verb. This is the verbs which are called auxiliary verbs. That is, has used, he has talked too much. This is the has, is, have, and has is auxiliary verbs, and talk is the action verb. Here, she has given medicine. The rain has stopped, otherwise we can use it has stopped. So here we have used auxiliary verb as well as past participle. Now that means in negative sentence also we can use, and in interrogative sentence also we can use while using these sentences. In the negative sentence, let us see that, you know, first of all, I have, first person, I have eaten biscuits, I have not eaten biscuits. Then you have eaten the biscuits and you have not eaten the biscuits. Otherwise that you have not given the book. Third one, third person it is, he has not yet come. He has come is a positive tense, and negative sentence is he has not yet come. In the interrogative sentence, I have not written here, you can use that. One example I'll say, see, I have not eaten the food. For example, if you want to ask any question, interrogative means questions only. Have you eaten the food? Have you? Have comes first, then you. Have you eaten the food? Otherwise, that means, has he not come to school? Has he not completed the work? Like this way, question marks comes in the end. Has comes first in the third person. Have comes first in the first person and second person. Okay, today it is over.
Please like, share and subscribe to our channel. And thanks for watching the video.